Looking for something that's tasty and healthy? You may want to check out Ruby Jean's Juicery.
And it's a real treat. Owner Chris Good is here to show us a bowl that is so popular. It's in all the locations. But first, I want to hear a little bit about you because you're the owner. You've started this store that's now become such a trend around Kansas City.
Sure. So we started Ruby Jean's in 2015, named after my late grandmother. She died at 61 from type 2 diabetes. So once I got acclimated with health and understanding how I should treat my body, I decided, hey, let me tell a story that people can relate to, because we feel that there's a Ruby Jean in everybody's family.
Amazing. You are now expanding. You have how many locations around Kansas City?
So we have two currently in Kansas City, one in Springfield, Missouri.
Okay.
We're going to launch a food truck here soon.
Amazing.
Wow. A new one coming up next weekend.
What's the popularity been like? Obviously, people have been flocking to those locations if you need to expand.
Sure. I call us the conscience of Kansas City. There's so much good food in Kansas City that people sometimes need to detox.
I've had barbecue all day. Okay, this is a popular item that you're making. Is it pronounced acai?
Acai.
It is. Okay, I've heard it pronounced both ways.
We get all kinds of pronunciations in the store, but this is our acai bowl. And historically, we've done one with a fruit base, but for our Whole Foods opening, we came up with one that's special to that location.
Okay.
So we have our acai, which is a Brazilian berry. It's native of Brazil.
Oh.
The special thing about our acai is that it is imported directly from Brazil to Kansas City. It makes no stops.
Really?
Wow. So you have Brazilian berry there. Then we will top this one with granola.
Okay. So, what kind of granola is that? Because it looks a little different.
So it's a blueberry strudel granola.
Sure enough.
So this is a new granola.
So that's homemade granola?
It is.
Okay. Wow.
It is. And then we've got our fresh banana.
Bananas.
So we'll line the bowl with some bananas there.
Okay.
And we get a lot of people that do custom acai bowls. This one will be available at our Whole Foods location.
Oh, okay.
So Saturday we'll open there, and this one will be available there.
Awesome.
So you got all your banana. You've got fresh cashew.
Okay. Hold off on the...
Yep, hold off on the almond butter.
Okay.
You help me out there in a second.
You're excited about the butter.
When I try to help, this is what happens. Just hang on, Nicole, hang on.
We've got some fresh dried cranberries.
Okay. Mm.
So this one is one that I take pride in. We did a lot of taste testing, a lot of no's.
And this was the yes.
So okay. We've got also some dark chocolate, just a little bit.
Don't be too liberal with that.
just a little dark chocolate. It's good for you in moderation. Then if you want to help me with the almond butter, let's see if it'll...
Yep.
Just a little dollop there.
Right on top. That looks delicious.
Perfect.
Okay.
And last but not least, you've got your honey drizzle. Mm. It'll come out of there. Let's take that guy off of there. And I love honey. You can go overboard with it, but we'll do a little honey drizzle, and that'll do it.
And there you go. Amazing. Okay, tell us about, because your opening is coming up this coming weekend, right, Whole Foods?
It is. So Saturday, August 17th at 11:11 a.m., we'll cut the ribbon alongside our mayor, and we'll open up.
11:11?
Yes. You want to know about that?
I have to know. Do we have time to hear about this? Tell us the Cliff Notes version.
11:11 is something I've been seeing on the clock for, years, maybe over a decade now. My son's name is Levin. Our downtown location is 11:11 Main. So every opening we do is at 11:11.
I love that. Very good story. Chris, thank you for coming
in.
We appreciate it.